I'm David Pountney. I'm the Artistic Director and Chief Executive of Welsh National Opera.
My name's Ian Douglas. I'm Company Manager.
My name's Katie Heath-Jones and I'm a Deputy Stage Manager.
My name is Lothar Königs and I'm very proud to be the Music Director of Welsh National Opera.
I'm Richard Norton. I work as a production manager.
I'm Helen Greenaway. I'm a mezzo-soprano in the chorus.
I'm Katrina McKinnon.
My name's Polly Graham.
My name is Michael Clifton Thompson.
I'm Oscar and I'm a costume maker.
Hi, I'm Patrick King. I'm the timpanist with the orchestra. The noisy one at the back.
Well, WNO is, I think, an organisation that sits on a very firm pedestal. It has a fantastic collective in terms of its chorus and its orchestra. Very, very high standard music making and professionalism in those two essential groups. And it has a very strong team of people involved in management.
I started work for the company in 1976. I didn't have any musical background. I liked music, but it was more Bruce Springsteen rather than Pavarotti. I then just fell in love with the theatre, with music, with the backstage, with the front of house, the smell of the grease paint.
What does opera mean to me? Well, before I got this job, opera meant nothing to me. And since I've got my job, it's meant everything to me. My job's changed my life and it's opened up to me a whole new art form I didn't even know. And the first opera I worked on was Madame Butterfly, and to hear that sung live by singers without any miking over an orchestra, it was just quite unbelievable. And I feel very privileged to do the job I do because I listen to some of the best singers in the world day in, day out.
My responsibilities are to deliver the set and the rest of the technical facilities, you know, for each production that I'm engaged in. So yeah, that's my job really. I played a character called Ryan in Neighbours probably about 91, 92. And then I played a character called Simon in Home and Away 93, 94 here. There's a huge reward you get out of technical theatre as well as, you know, being on stage. It's, you know, and it's great to have an overview of what happens. I think that sometimes gives me a different perspective than maybe other people in technical, the fact that I understand what's going on when people walk on stage.
I've been with WNO in the chorus for 28 years now, and we've always maintained a very good reputation. We're more like a family here. I think it's something to do with our roots.
It's a really good crowd, basically. A lot of very talented singers and actors. There's a lot of banter within the chorus, as I'm sure you can imagine. So we get through our production and music rehearsals on a day-to-day basis by secretly bantering.
At the moment, I'm doing some alterations to a costume for Vixen, which was originally built in 1980. So you can see how many people have worn it by the amount of labels. Tend to layer them up so you can get a reference of who's worn them in case the same artist wants to go back into it.
Working in such a big theatre, such a vast theatre as WMC, we've got a load of space, load of resources, big rehearsal rooms. We can wheel scenery up and down Scenery Street, in and out of rehearsal rooms, but then you've got to go and put it on some trailers and take it out on the road and fit into small venues such as Oxford or Southampton or Bristol.
That provides its own challenge, and life in a pit is good. You really do have to be part of a team in an orchestra, because you can have colleagues sat right on top of you, and especially with me playing such big loud instruments, I have to respect their health as well. So keeping an eye out and saying to them, oh, watch out, it's gonna be a loud bit coming, or, you know, I'll just keep this bit down in rehearsal.
We recently did Tristan by Wagner, and that was 5 hours, which is a long play, hard work, but, you know, it's just fantastic music.
Oh God, the typical day starts around 6:30, 7 o'clock. I get up, I do some emails, I have a bath, I have breakfast. I'm a very serious breakfast eater. I cycle to work across the barrage of Cardiff Bay, which this morning was quite a cold experience, I can tell you.
I'm thrilled to have David Pountney as my colleague, friend, partner, and chief executive and artistic director. And I think we speak pretty the same language.
Through the day, I will walk around with my iPad because I need to keep up with emails in between my rehearsals. And there probably may be a meeting at lunchtime. There may well be another meeting at the end of rehearsals that finish around 5:30.
It's very risky, but it's very exciting. There's so many elements could go wrong at any point. But at the same time, when it works, it just celebrates that kind of union of all the different artistic elements working together. And I guess that's why everyone finds it so compelling. That's why I find it compelling.
You will experience a very sensual, overwhelming opera evening.
Opera for me means a communal experience of all the highest and most powerful emotions of which human beings are capable.
Do you know, when I bring somebody to Welsh National Opera for the first time, it's a great thing to do. It's one of the things I get the biggest buzz out of. In the last year, I've perhaps brought 30, 40 people, odd taxi drivers, friends of my parents-in-law, and to see them react to what we are putting on stage is truly special. They have no idea of, you know, the number of times people say, I've never been to an opera before. I say, come along, come see Madame Butterfly, come and see The Cunning Little Vixen, come and see Die Meistersinger. It's just fantastic to see them at the end of a performance saying, I never knew it could be anything like this. It's the best thing in the world, a huge buzz.